show clicky. So angry and clicky. How is that good? You're trying to listen to your game and you got that going. Too loud. Impact, pretty sure it's an impact. Is it an impact? Yes, it's an impact. SCUF PS4 impact. And we've got a dead right to trigger. Doesn't even move. Rock solid. But everything else seems to work a-okay. Amazingly, the paddles work. So, we need to get this apart and figure out what's going on with that trigger. So we have the dreaded SCUF security screw. We have a modified game bit. Tweet. There we go. Liberated that evil little screw. That screw from SCUF tells we have something to hide rather than we are protecting a warranty. Here's the working left trigger. We have the switch. That little white thing there is the actual plunger. That's what makes the click. And then we have this retainer here. This is a standard PS4 trigger, as you can see there, just hits that plunger. There's like a little bit of play before it hits it, and then click on the right one that you've broken. Nothing there. This is going to be a quick and easy repair. So if we take that out, he says quick and easy. The switch could probably need replacing. Now you see how this part here is bent up. Shouldn't be like that. If we look at the left hand side and compare them. The left one working, right one not working. See the difference? They are. That one is horseshoe shaped, the other one is straight. So before I go replacing this, I'm just going to straighten this. Nice easy repair you could do at home. If SCUF didn't put that evil security screw in it. So I have straightened that out and we'll see if the switch actually works. Or if something else is going on here. So it's now hitting the white plunger. But there's no air gap. So if we put this one back on. Okay, so we've got a little bit of play before it hits the plunger and then it actuates. And to be honest, that's good. This side doesn't have any play at all, so that'll be really easy to tap accidentally. So what I'm going to do, because that's been stressed, I'm going to replace this R2 trigger for a new one. Okay, and SCUF do modify these a little bit. They shave a little bit off the edge here, and also they clip off this side as well. So first of all, let's just see how that fits, and it doesn't, so we definitely need to modify it slightly, a little bit at a time, and then just test fit until we get the same feel both sides. Okay, and again, test fit. Okay, we've got it doing the same, so we still need more off. Okay, hopefully I haven't taken too much away there. Okay, we're getting there, getting a nice solid click. And there's a little bit of play. I'd like a little bit more play, because if you look at this one, there is a bit of gap between the edge and the white plunger. There's a little bit of an air gap. And again, rinse and repeat. There we go, we've got a bit of an air gap now. So we have repaired this controller. Nice, easy repair. I was hoping for something a little bit more complicated. And no matter where you press the button, it fires. Good.